Hello, welcome to this tutorial. Let's see in a short time everything you need to know to start using Adobe Premiere Pro CC Release 2019. Leave us tips and suggestions below this video to improve our next video guides dedicated to Create Cloud. Premiere Pro is the most important video editing software inside Creative Cloud. This is used to create professional videos with visual and audio media by applying advanced corrections, titles, effects, and transitions. This product is available just under a subscription plan. When opening Premiere, the home screen shows up, divided into sections. Inside Home, you can take a quick tour on the software and pick up any recent file to start. Under Sync Settings, you can gather your own custom settings from your Adobe account. Below, use New Project and Open Project to start with a new or an existing project made on your own. Use Open Premiere Rush Project to start using Premiere Rush, a simpler version of Premiere Pro used to make quick adjustments on your videos before sharing these online. We won't see these in this beginner tutorial. To see how to use Premiere Pro, let's just start from a new empty project. On New Project, type the project name and click on Browse to set where to save it. Under General, adjust the time format between seconds with time code and number of frames. When all is set, just go to OK. The new project is open on the main interface of Premiere Pro with several windows open, which can change according to the kind of workspace chosen on top, from Assembly to Libraries. In this video, we will use just the default one called Editing, but you can also use the Learning one to get tips and suggestions through the Learn panel on the left. On the left, you have all the windows collecting media, effects, and properties. On the right, you have the main preview to check your project in progress and the project timeline where you work with your media files and modify these with the editing tools on the left side. In case you miss any window, you can open it by using the Window tab. Before starting with Premiere, let's understand the basic structure of any project. Each Premiere project is made by multiple and independent structures called sequences, where each sequence is composed by copies of pictures, videos, or sound files called clips, edited and placed accordingly. For simplicity, we will work on a project with a single sequence. At first, a new project has no sequences inside. You can create a new one by using Control or Command and N and adjusting video and audio options on the New Sequence dialog box. On Sequence Presets, pick a ready template from the list on the left or go to Settings to use your own options. You can choose a defined template under Editing Mode or make your own with Custom. Set the frame rate to use on Time Base, the video resolution on frame size, and the sample rate for the audio output more below. Under Tracks and VR Video, adjust other settings such as the stereo channels and the virtual reality options. Once you are ready, go to OK to create the new sequence and open it on the project timeline. At this point, you can start importing your media files. To add files, you can drag and drop these from any computer folder into the timeline directly. You can also open the Media Browser window to look for your files and drop these inside your project. All the sequences made and the media files imported are collected inside the project window on the left, complete with name and details. You can double-click on these to open the Source window above and get a complete preview of both video frames and sound waveforms. In case of videos with audio, you can select the content to check at the bottom. Below, use the player to play back and pause. adjusting the preview quality on playback resolution. You can also save a snapshot of the current frame by using Export Frame. All the media files imported inside the timeline are shown as rectangles called clips, extended in time, and colored according to their type. Pink for pictures, green for sound files, and blue for video frames and audio. These clips are collected within several rows. On top, you have the video tracks with a V letter and a number, collecting all your visual clips. At the bottom, you have the audio tracks with an A letter with all the sound files, recordings, and any speech. You can check your timeline content through time by using your mouse wheel. If you also hold down the Alt key, you will zoom in and out around your pointer. Each clip shows a quick preview of its content if you zoom in enough or enlarge tracks by clicking and dragging their edges. Visual clips show frame thumbnails, and audio clips show their own waveform, one per stereo channel. To get a complete preview of your timeline content, you can use the program window on top. This has the player and the same option seen for source preview, with the difference that the program preview shows the timeline content with all its edited clips where the blue marker is placed. You can place this in time by clicking above the timeline or click and drag it to check the project frame by frame. Now, let's see how to edit the timeline clips by using the selection tool. To move a clip in time, just click and drag it within the same track or in another one. Make sure not to overlap clips on the same track or part of these gets cut. In case of video clips with audio, you move and edit both of its frames and audio together. To make these independent, just right-click on these and go to Unlink. The video tracks order is very important to define which visual clip must be shown in front of other clips overlapping in time. All the clips inside higher video tracks in position are always shown in front of all the others located on lower video tracks. To stretch or shorten any clip in time, just click and drag its edges. In case of videos and audio clips, you can just shorten these, removing part of their content. To stretch and shorten clips without affecting their content, you can use the Rate Stretch tool or the R key. This changes the speed rate of the clip as you drag its edges. If you shorten it, its speed rate is increased above 100%, and the clip will be played faster. If you stretch it, the clip is played slower, with a percentage below 100%. Clips with changed speed rate also get a yellow FX icon turned on. To cut, copy, and paste a clip, just click on it to select it and use Control or Command and X, C, and V. You can cut a clip to remove it quickly. When you paste, the copy of the clip is placed where the blue marker is. To undo any action, you can use Control or Command and Z or the History window on the left, going through your past actions made inside the project. To split a clip in multiple pieces, enable the Razor tool and click on the clip directly. On the left side of the timeline, you have several options to manage the content inside each video or audio track. You can use the eye icon on any video track to hide or show its content inside. Inside audio tracks, you can use the Mute M button to mute all the clips inside the track, or the Solo S button to mute all the other audio tracks except the interested one. You can also enable the microphone button to start recording on the audio track. Start from the timeline marker. Consider that this overwrites any content that overlaps. Video and audio tracks also show a lock button. When this is enabled, it is not possible to apply modifications on the track content until you unlock it. To add or remove tracks, just right-click on any empty space on the left. On the extreme right, you also have a decibel meter, indicating the output volume level of your project. This should never reach red colors, otherwise your audio may be saturated and distorted. In this case, you can reduce the overall volume by using the volume gain level on the master audio track. Now, let's see how to adjust the appearance of any clip. As you select a clip from the timeline, the Effect Controls window on the left shows with all the clip properties divided in sections. When selecting a picture, you can use motion to adjust its position, its size with scale, and its inclination with rotation. Use opacity to adjust the transparency level of the clip. You can change the property value by clicking once on it and typing inside, or clicking and dragging on it directly. Edited clips also get a yellow FX icon on the timeline. You can also use the FX icon on each section to enable or disable your changes, and compare these with the original setup. Use the reset button on the right to reset any property. When selecting audio clips, you can adjust the overall volume and the level of each channel with channel volume. You can balance the left and the right stereo channels with panner. When selecting videos, you get both the properties for the visual frames and the audio part. Inside Premiere, you can also add visual and audio effects by using the Effects window in the bottom left corner. Just browse for the effect you want to import and drag and drop it on a clip directly. This will show a colored FX icon. The effect applied is added inside the Effect Controls window with all its options, which can be edited and customized as seen for the standard clip properties. To remove the effect from the list, just right-click on it and go to Clear. In addition, you can use Comparison View to compare the timeline content before and after the modifications you apply. Use the left preview to choose the timeline frame to check, and save the view by using the comparison button. At this point, the left preview locks on that timeline status, whereas the right preview shows its content with your next and final modifications. Inside the effects window, you can also find visual and audio transitions, which are special effects used to introduce or end with a clip in time. To apply transitions, just click and drag on any of the clip edges, or directly between two consecutive clips in time. The transition is shown with its name under a yellow background, and applies effects on the clip appearance in case of video transitions and on its volume in case of audio transitions. To edit the transition, just select it and use the Effect Controls window. To remove it, just right-click on it and go to Clear. To add text inside your project, just enable any type tool and click and drag on the program window to create a red text box used to delimit the text content you're going to type. Once created, click inside the box to start typing. The piece of text is shown on the timeline as a title clip in pink color, contained inside video tracks, and editable as seen for the other standard clips. To adjust the text properties, just select it and open the Effect Controls window. This collects the same properties seen for the visual clips, but also everything regarding titles under text, such as font, size, style, and distribution. Below, adjust the text color with fill and apply any stroke or shadow effect with defined color. You can also adjust some basic title properties directly on the program window while using the selection tool, which turns the text box into blue. At this point, you can click and drag within it to move, use its blue nodes to scale the box, and click and drag outside to rotate it. To save your project, just go to File, and then to Save As, choosing file name and location. Premiere projects are saved in a PRPROJ format with all its sequences, clip properties, effects, and transitions. Whereas to obtain your final video to play back and upload, just select the sequence interested and go to File, Export, and then to Media. This opens the Export Settings dialog box with a big preview on the left and all the rendering options on the right. Choose the video format under Format and a Ready Template under Preset. For HD or 4K optimized YouTube settings, choose H.264 as Format and choose HD or 4K YouTube presets. On Output Name, set the video name and its location. Below, you can fully customize the video and the audio settings such as resolution, frame rate, and audio codec. By default, these are matched with the source files you use, but you can uncheck the square on the right to apply your changes. To match your media files again, use the Match Source button. On the left side, use the Source page to crop the video as you like, and the triangular markers below to select the part of the whole sequence to export. Once you are ready, just click on the Export button below. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing and outstanding video guides for Adobe Creative Cloud.